6 years ago, we started an amazing journey sailing around the world to find low-tech solutions that can face these challenges.
Difficult access to safe water, clean energy, healthy food, or waste management.
By local means and appropriate technologies. We have been in 25 countries and studied more than 50 low-tech innovations. We tried each of them on board our floating lab in order to document and promote them so that anybody can replicate them.
Today we'll show you a selection of our favorite low-tech.
The cleanest energy is the one we don't consume. So the first step on board was to question our needs. And only then, we thought about renewable and efficient ways to meet those needs.
So for example, we don't have an electric fridge. We use a pantry to store most of our food and a zeopot, a traditional fridge we discovered in Morocco. We don't have an electric oven. We cook and pasteurize food with a solar cooker. Like Victoria in Mexico and Alan from the US. On board, we also need tools. But instead of using powerful electric ones, we use a pedal-powered machine, inspired from Maya Pedal in Guatemala. And to charge our phones and our little computer, we built this wind turbine in Senegal from a recycled printer motor.
Finally, we use solar panels, but very few compared to what we would have needed if we were fully electric.
In case there's no sun, we can produce biogas from organic waste, as we learned in Nicaragua with Blue Energy. And if there's no sun and no biogas, we use a rocket stove. A super efficient wood stove we discovered with Dawiyani in India.
Because we like to eat fresh while sailing, we are growing some food on board.
In Thailand, we studied how to raise crickets because they are an incredible source of protein and fat. We even grow edible algae, which are also rich in protein, as in the spirulina farm we documented in Madagascar and New York. We also like to harvest fresh leaves for our tea or meals with our bioponic systems that we studied in Singapore. Mushrooms are delicious and rich in minerals. We study how to grow them in Mexico and Thailand. When we sail for a few days, we dehydrate them and the fresh fruits to preserve them, as Polly and Rod do in Mexico with the leftover food. In the kitchen, you will find lacto-fermentations and we make soda from peels. With all these small food productions on board, we can have rich and varied meals. It's economical and we know where it comes from.
Mmh, oh, c'est trop bon.
On the boat, most of the waste become resources for the ecosystem.
Urine is precious. One part feeds the spirulina and we give the other part to the biofilter. Some good bacteria transform it into a great fertilizer for the bioponic system. The organic waste go to our larvae like in Malaysia. Even our dry toilets. When the larvae are big, we dehydrate them, grind them and give the powder to the crickets. The compost goes to the biodigester that makes gas for the stove and a liquid fertilizer. The cardboard and coffee ground are digested by the mushrooms. And we try to avoid other wastes by repairing everything that breaks and sorting what we have to throw away, like they do in Kamikatsu in Japan.
Most of our water, we collect it from the rain.
We have also tried to produce fresh water from salty water, thanks to evaporation.
But it still has to be improved.
To drink and cook, we purify our water thanks to a ceramic water filter produced by Ecofiltro in Guatemala. They are very efficient and affordable. To water the plants and wash ourselves, we filter it thanks to a biosand filter. Another technology using sand and microorganisms that could be used to produce drinkable water.
Our journey has led us to study many of bio-based materials.
On board, we did many experiments with mushrooms-based materials. We repaired a surfboard. We grew a thermos. And we insulated a solar oven with this material. In California, we even met a lady who grew close with kombucha.
Living low-tech, it's not going back in the past. It's going forward a future of an optimized sobriety. And it's really exciting.
More than techniques, low-tech became for me a philosophy.
We could reinvent our way of life to be more healthy, fulfilling and sustainable. We believe that we could face our global challenges if a network of local entrepreneurs and organizations implement low-tech solutions.
That's why we want to share all this know-how. You can find all the video tutorials on our YouTube channel and the written tutorials on our wiki. It's open source and collaborative, so feel free to join us like hundreds of people have.
Wow, c'est hyper bon.
Oh.
Oh mon dieu! The goal of the low-tech lab is to. Oh, c'est vraiment une tuerie!
Est-ce que tu veux bien répéter le c'est vraiment une tuerie?
Ok.
Alors, ces champignons?
C'est délicieux!